when you look at Consumer Reports saying, hey, there's arsenic in this, it's like, hey, guess what? There's arsenic in brown rice too. So should we all stop eating brown rice? Cadmium, arsenic, lead, and mercury are probably the four highest toxic or common toxic elements that we'd have to worry about, but it's dose dependent just like anything. They're picking on arsenic because everybody knows that arsenic is poisonous, and it's like, it's a buzzword that can like get people's eyes to open a little bit and be like, oh my God, there's arsenic in there? There's probably arsenic in like 10 other foods that you eat. Where that comes down to is, are you resilient enough to handle that? So one of the big issues that we see even with folks that are pursuing performance but aren't crushing protein in a supplement form is, where are they sourcing their protein from? What's coming in along with the amino acids that we need? You have to judge the system by how well it can actually eliminate that. So our liver's amazing. It's designed to break down and get rid of toxins. So it would be foolish to say that we couldn't handle a specific toxic load, because that's what its job is, right? Now the question is, how much of a toxic burden can you handle? Where else is toxins coming from in your life? Now if you're overloaded, you live in a highly metropolitan city, and you're constantly bombarded with specific things, then your ability to handle the toxic burden is gonna be lower because your body's already working on that stuff. So in situations like that, it would be advantageous to stay away from things that would be contributing more, and that could be protein sources, or that could even be produce that's not organic. Better coaches will find ways to get people protein if they require it, and that could be by improving digestion rather than overloading the system.